What's up? My name is Abe Kislevitz. This is Caleb Farrow. We're from the GoPro media team. And today we're gonna go through all of the different modes in the camera, specifically the different resolutions, the different frame rates, and the different FOVs. And when used correctly in different situations, it'll really maximize the quality of your video. So let's dive in and figure out what each one does and what the benefits are and how we can use them.
That's great.
So starting at the top, the highest resolution in the GoPro is 4K. You can film 4K at 12 or 15 frames per second. While normal video is 30 frames per second, there's still a lot we can do with this. Since it's 4K, it's huge. It looks awesome for wide panoramas. Something up here, a time lapse of the sunset, anything like that will look awesome. Anything where you're doing high action or high movement, you probably don't want to use 4K. Moving right down the list, we've got 2.7K. 2.7K is one of my favorite modes in the cameras because it's such high resolution, crisp video, and you can still film at 30 frames per second, so it goes into a normal timeline. I use 2.7K for a lot of mounted shots, anything that's gonna be steady, and anything where I know I don't need slow motion. This interview that we're doing right now on this camera is 2.7K, and that camera over there is also 2.7K. Perfect examples of where I can have fluid motion, 30 frames per second video, and ultra high resolution. There's a couple things we can do with the high resolution. We can either drop it into a 1080 timeline and crop in or resize, or we can just scale it down. Moving right on down the list, we've got 1440. 1440 is one of our favorite modes at GoPro, and we use it for everything POV. So 1440p is essentially the same resolution as 1080p, but it's essentially taller. It's a 4:3 aspect ratio. So it looks more like a square, and you have more view above and below what would be a 1080 file. So chest cam, head cam while we're doing our biking here, head cam skiing. So anything where I want to see more view above and below, where if you're skiing, you might want to see your tips of your skis and the horizon. And if we're mountain biking, we want to see below where we can see the trail, the handlebars, and the horizon in front of us. So next on the list is 1080p, and this is one of the most versatile modes in the camera just because it's full HD and you can film it at 60 frames per second all the way down to 24. So you can get that fluid slow motion if you need it. So at GoPro, we use 1080p for anything where we know we need slow motion, we film at 60 frames per second, and it's not body mounted where we'll need that additional above and below the 1080p frame. So anything from follow cam, skiing, mounted shots, handheld, B-roll, car-mounted shots, those are all perfect examples of when to use 1080. It's pretty much the best all-around mode in the GoPro, so if you're not really sure which mode to use, I would go for 1080-60. So moving down the list, we've got 1080 Super. Now, 1080 Super is a new mode for the Hero 3 Plus, and it's essentially taking 1440p, but squishing it down into a 1080 file. And it pinches the center, so the center still looks normal, and it's a little more skewed on the outsides. What this does for you is you still get the top and bottom vertical view of 1440, but it puts it into that standard 1080p mode. 1080p Super is great for head cam, chest cam, or anything POV that's going straight in front of you. Next up is 960p. 960 is similar to 1440p, but it's a lower resolution. It's actually pretty much the same thing as 720p, but it has additional room above and below the frame. The benefit of using 960p over 1440p is that it can film at up to 100 frames per second. So if you know you want to really capture that perfect POV high action moment, 960p is your go-to. Next, we've got 720p, and 720p is great because it can do ultra high slow motion. It can film at 120 frames per second. So if you know you've got something super high action and you don't need the above and below frame for the POV that we like to do, then 720p is your go-to mode. This is great for Instagram videos, for anything that you don't really need that high extra resolution. So next on the list is 720 Super View, and that's a really similar mode to 1080 Super View, but just lower resolution. So it takes that 4:3 aspect ratio, the extra view above and below the frame, and squishes it into a 720p frame. And last but not least on the list is Wvga 240. Wvga is a lower resolution mode than 720p, and it can film up to 240 frames per second. It's not gonna look great blown up on a huge TV, but if you're doing something for the web or Instagram video, it's an awesome mode to use and just experiment with really cool slow motion effects. Now that we've gone through all of the resolutions and frame rates in the GoPro, the last thing that we can choose when choosing a video mode is the FOV, which stands for field of view. So when you're changing the FOV and going from wide to medium to narrow, you're essentially zooming in your video. And it does this by way of cropping in on the sensor, which isn't the same thing as a digital zoom, so it still retains high quality video and at the same resolution, but it zooms in on your footage. So at GoPro, we use wide for pretty much anything where we need that immersive view. You really get a better sense of smoother footage if you're using wide. If you know you can do some pretty smooth shots or static video, try out medium and narrow and just see how it affects the video, how it zooms in and gives you a totally different feel than you're used to with a GoPro. The one thing to consider when you're thinking about resolutions versus frame rates is there's a trade-off. If you want a higher frame rate, you have to go down to a lower resolution, so you're getting essentially a lower quality video. But think about what your end goal is if you need high resolution or if you need high frame rate. Think about what the FOV should be, what the activity is, and just try to experiment with all different sorts of the modes in the camera.